In this video, I'm going to show you how to play a bunch of retro arcade and console games online with your friends for free using Fightcade 2. This is Steve from Restalgia, and let's get started. What is going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, go down below the video, hit the thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and make sure to turn on notifications so you don't miss any of my upcoming videos. Now, in this video, like I said, we are going to focus in on Fightcade, which is a platform or a software that allows you to play retro arcade or console games against your friends online, and it's all free, which is really awesome. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys all of the steps to get this installed and up and running to play any game that you really want to that's compatible. What we're going to need is a few things to get started. First, we are going to need to navigate over to the Fightcade website. Now, as you can see, it says that this is the best way to play retro games online. And after playing around with it, I'd actually say this is a really good system, assuming you've got a fairly stable internet connection. Now, it is available for download for Windows, Mac, and Linux users. However, it is not currently available for the Raspberry Pi. However, I believe there's probably some workarounds that can be done, and I will try to make a video about that in the future. What you'll need to do to get started is go ahead and grab the version in which you need. In my case, I'm going to need the Windows version. So I'll go ahead and click on that to download. I'm going to save it right to my desktop, and it's gonna go ahead and download. Next, while it's downloading, what you're gonna wanna do is click on this register button. In order to play with Fightcade Online, you do need to have some sort of an account, and you do need to register that on their website. So you can go ahead and create an account. In this case, I'll go ahead and create a Restalgia account. Once you've gone ahead and entered in all of your credentials, you can go ahead and hit register. And that's pretty much it. Now your user has been created and you can go ahead and log into that. The next thing that we're actually gonna download is a JSON pack. And I'm gonna leave links to all of this information in the description down below. But essentially what this JSON file or set of files is going to do will be to allow you to click on whatever game you want within the actual software and just play that game. You don't need to add the ROMs, you don't need to find the ROMs. The JSON file will specifically select the game in which you're running, verify whether or not you have that ROM on your computer, and if not, it will go up to a server, grab the ROM and download it directly to your machine. Now, the obvious advantages here is that you don't need to source the ROM files yourself. The JSON files can do that, but I do want to make note that there are no ROMs included in this zip file. It simply contains the JSON files, which do all the work, which again is totally fine. So we're going to go ahead and click that. We're going to save it to our desktop as well. And now we've got everything that we really need to get this up and running. Okay, so now we are on our desktop. As you can see, we've got the Fightcade installer, which is the latest version as of today's date. And we've also got that FC2 ROMs JSON pack that's available for us as well. First thing that we want to do is install Fightcade, and it's going to pop up and ask you if you want to install Fightcade. The answer to that, of course, is yes. It's gonna ask you where you want to install it. I'm gonna leave it in the default directory. In my case, it's gonna be in the documents folder and within a folder called Fightcade. That's fine. We'll hit okay. During the installation process, you're going to be prompted to install DirectX. That's totally fine. You may already have it on your computer. In my case, I believe I do, but it still will prompt you, accept the agreement and hit next. And hit next one more time, and it's going to try to install the software. Once DirectX has finished installing, we can go ahead and hit finish. And now it's gonna let us know that Fightcade was successfully installed. So we can go ahead and hit okay. And now we should have a Fightcade 2 icon on our desktop. Now, before we go ahead and jump into Fightcade, we still need to make use of that JSON pack. What we're gonna do is highlight it, we're gonna right click on it, we're gonna go ahead and extract it to its own folder on the desktop. We're gonna double click on that new folder. And within this folder, you are going to be able to see all of the different JSON files and a couple of text files for change logs and version numbers. What we need to do is transplant these files into one of the directories for Fightcade 2. And if you're not sure where it installed or you forget, it's no big deal. All you have to do is right-click on the actual application and hit Open File Location. Now we've got our file location opened up. There's our Fightcade 2 application, and you can see we've got a number of different folders here. We've got a ROMs folder, and that's going to show us that currently you can run SNES, Dreamcast, or Naomi, and then you can run arcade games using either the Final Burn Neo emulator or the Final Burn Alpha emulator. Additionally, here is where you would upload your ROMs if you already have them. So if you've got some SNES ROMs, you would double click this folder and dump them directly into here. But with the JSON files that we have, we actually don't need to source our own ROMs. That's going to be pretty handy because if you wanted to load this up with every compatible game, it would be tens of gigabytes worth of data. And we don't want to have to deal with that. What we want is to use these JSON files to be able to cherry pick and hand pick the ROMs specifically that we want to play. So we're going to go ahead and go back to the main directory. We're going to go into our emulators folder. And in here, you're going to have all of the information and folders for the emulators. But what we actually want to do is just drag and drop these items into this folder.
Yes.
Once they are here, you're pretty much done. There isn't anything else that you need to do. So let's go ahead and click on the Fightcade 2 application. Now, as soon as the application opens up, you're going to be prompted to log in. We're going to need to log in with that username and password that we created earlier on their website. And there we go. Now we have fully logged in. We are ready to go. So at this stage, there are a number of things we can take a peek at. They have an About Us section. They've got a manual that'll explain everything in very fine details. And then there's also an FAQ section for frequently asked questions. If you go ahead and click on this magnifying glass over on the left-hand side, that is your search function. We're going to click there, and by default, it's going to display all of the games that are currently available based upon the number of available users or online users that are playing those games at any given moment. In this case, you can take a look here. You've got Street Fighter Third Strike. That is currently got 395 online players. And as you can see, you can go ahead on and take a look at multiple pages, but rather than searching for your game within the system, you can actually go right up to the top in the search game channels, and you can actually just type in the game you want to look for. So if you want to look for Turtles in Time, as an example, you just write in Turtles, and you're going to be given any game that matches that title, and it'll tell you whether it is for the Mega Drive, if it's a Super Nintendo game, if it's an arcade game, etc. So you just pick the one that you want, and you can go ahead and click on it. In this case, I'm going to go ahead and grab Turtles in Time for the Super Nintendo just to show you guys how that works. In order to play the game, you need to select the plus join button, which allows you to join the lobby. So once you click on that, that's when the JSON file is going to populate, and you're going to see it'll automatically download the game if you don't have it. Once that's done, you're going to see that there is a lobby right over on the left-hand column. We're going to click on that, and now we are inside the lobby able to play the game. Now, there's a few different things that you could do. If there were multiple people here, you could click on them, and you could actually challenge them and play with them online. Or you can go ahead and play by yourself by pressing the test game button. Emulator is going to launch with that game playing. And obviously, like I said, I didn't download that game or anything along those lines, but the JSON file took care of all of that for me. The next thing that we have to do here is edit the inputs. So you can select input configuration, and then you can manually map this any which way you want. By default, it's going to be mapped to a keyboard. Once you are happy with the way that it is mapped, you can hit the OK button, and then you can go on and play your game. Now, if you ever want to exit the game, you simply just exit the emulator. Now, I'm going to go ahead and find a game that has some online players, and I'll show you guys how that works. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at X-Men versus Street Fighter for arcade. We're going to hit the plus join button, and as you can see right on screen, it's going to check to see if we have the ROMs, and if not, it will automatically download it through that JSON file. Once that's done, you're going to notice that the lobby is over and available to us on the left-hand side, but I do want to mention that if you already have downloaded the game, you will not be prompted to re-download it. For example, if I exit that channel and I try to join that X-Men versus Street Fighter section again, I'm not going to be prompted to download or install anything simply because we already have the ROM in the correct folder at this stage and there's nothing to download. So we can go ahead and enter into that channel, and you can see there are a number of players that are available to play that are actually looking for somebody to play with. There's also going to be a number of people who are not currently available as well, and this is going to change based on time zones and number of users that are currently seeking to play. So before you jump into any sort of game, if you're launching a new game for a new emulator, it's always best to go into test the game. It's going to launch, and then the first thing that you want to do is go into your inputs, and then you want to map your inputs for your controller. As I said, everything is currently predefined to map on a keyboard, which is okay, but if you want to play with a fight stick or a controller, you are going to have to go in here and remap buttons. Now, if we want to actually challenge somebody to a game, we can go ahead and double click on their name, and it's going to give us several different options. You've got first to 2 wins, first to 3 wins, first to 5, first to 10, first to 20, or an unranked match. I'm going to go ahead and hit unranked, and I'm going to pursue that challenge and wait to see if this person will accept it. So this person hasn't accepted. We're going to go ahead and cancel. We're going to try to find somebody else and see if they're interested. This person just commented in the thread, so let's see if he's willing to accept a challenge as well. So I've actually been challenged. We're going to go ahead and cancel the challenge that I made, and I'm going to accept this challenge from this user. And what's going to happen next is the game is going to load and connect in through peer-to-peer gaming. Ready. And there you guys have it. As you can see, I totally lost there, but that's totally fine. I'm using a keyboard. That's pretty much it. I mean, the online experience is pretty good. And as I said, in order to exit, you just simply close out the emulator. And that is pretty much all that I've got for you guys in terms of this video. This is Fightcade 2, which very well may be one of the best ways to play a lot of these arcade games online against your friends for free. But that is pretty much all I've got for you guys in this video. Let me know down below what your thoughts are on Fightcade 2 and if you are already a part of the action. Thank you so very much for watching, and I will talk to you guys again real soon.